Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the RaidCall EMS One Summer Group Stage, where we have Netolic RU going up against Imaginary Gaming, trying to use themselves as a source of inspiration for murder on the dance floor. Let's see how we go in game number two. Who's going to be tiptoeing around this one? We're going to find out together, myself and Capitalist, together, forever. Casting data for you. Welcome back.
I wonder how many people actually get some of your more musically inclined references.
Well, if they were brought up in the 1990s, then probably, yeah. But if they're not, then it's like, yeah. It's like people knowing what Pocahontas was. And then, like, they watch Avatar, and they're like, ha-ha! Pocahontas was a copy of Avatar! I'm like, well... yeah.
Well, League of Legends is, the original...
Whoa! Hold the phone before Russell Crowe throws it.
All right, well, game two. Hopefully we'll see just as much action, but a little bit more, you know, even.
yeah, it was maybe just...
Not as much one-sided game.
Bumping both ways would be good. Yeah.
That was really entertaining, and hopefully we see a lot more action again. Netolic is already setting themselves up for the same exact lineup.
Yep.
We got Naga, we got
Keeper of the Light. The only thing they won't have this time around is the Batrider, but he wasn't really involved anyway. So who cares? And they didn't ban out the Latrak. The combination is still there for Netolic RU, and they're going up against an SD and a Chen. And I'm really surprised to see a Chen pick up different Imaginary Gaming. Like, you saw how aggressive Netolic RU were with their lane with the Coddle and Naga before. They get one center. It could be a Leaner, it could be a Latrak. The Latrak was really nice because it allowed them to push down the towers. But in this scenario, they could just go all out killing. Who gives a crap about the lone Druid? Who's going to be going long lane in this scenario? Or at least that would be the summary. I highly doubt they're going to try and run an SD and a Chen against them, and yeah, there's the combo. Why break the winning combo, man? But with the Chen and an SD up now for Imaginary Gaming, they're gonna run that on the bottom lane, a lone druid on the top lane. You could already feel, and a Tinker. You know how I was talking about Imaginary Gaming, and we saw that game up against Quantic, and Tinker was banned as the first two every single game. They know that if things get rough, if people want to initiate on them, they just get staller heroes. They get heroes like Tinker to buy them the space to get the farm up and get back out again. And they're going to need it. They're going to need it because Chen's going to find no love in whatsoever. But with a Bounty Hunter now on the field, they've got an option for ganking the Tinker. And also a hero that can also push Lone Druid out of the lane. Gets pulled a little bit more early stages. He could actually push Lone Druid off that top lane.
Yeah. No, you're absolutely right. This is one of those lanes that you have to be given centuries to be able to do well in. So he can do all right if he gets the early Orb of Venom, right, and he has down his supports give him centuries and able to throw those down. He can do decently well. It's better if he's in the safe lane. I almost wonder if Imaginary Gaming, if they want to go for, just because of the pure, unadulterated aggression coming out of Netolic, if they want to go something, well, okay, maybe not. Maybe not. In fact, I mean, with all the Dragonites we've been seeing middle, but this looks like a Dragonite tri-lane. It could be a Tinker tri-lane, actually. We've seen that before, especially since it's going to be a dual lane with Chen. You're not going to be gimping Tinker's experience as much, but we've seen it run aggressively as in the off lane, and that's because they usually like to be able to stack Ancients with one of their supports, but that's still viable. Dragonite can still go over and stack the, okay. All right, see, okay, what I was originally going to say was they could do a lone druid tri-lane just because of the aggression coming out of Netolic, but it doesn't look like that it's going to be the case. Instead, they're going to be doing, like, a dual lane Tinker with Dragonite mid.
Weird. Well, let's actually do something which we didn't do in our last game. And I'm sorry, but I apologize for it. We didn't run through players because everyone decided to start killing each other before we even started. So we'll have Sky as our lone druid on the top lane. We'll have middle lane. We bans as there.
Where's your mute button now?
Toby? I couldn't reach it. I tried. I'm sorry. I have a sensitive nose.
First the microphone won't go off, then it won't shut down.
Oh, give me a break. Life is not easy. Actually, life is really great. Sky, top lane, lone druid. Middle lane, bans with no sneeze. Will be the TK there. We'll have Vlad as the Chen inside the jungle. It puts Zadrot, who is the stand-in here for Imaginary Gaming, as a role as the SD, who now finds a bounty hunter with Illusion Rune. Not a good place to be. And then Sev will be the Tinker on the bottom lane. Of course, that bounty hunter on the bottom lane. We worked out how to say his name before. I'm going to come back to it with the exact way how to pronounce his name. Unless you remember. Do you remember how to say the bounty hunter's name?
No, you know I don't keep track of names.
Luckily,
just call him bounty hunter.
Luckily, I have a reference sheet, so we'll get back to it in a minute. Eli's going to be the Storm Spirit in the middle lane, and that puts FNG. It's a defensive lane on the top lane of Dota Stalk as the Naga, Android as the Latrak, and FNG as the Keeper of the Light. So good luck there, Lone Droid. He's going to need it. He's really going to need it. Android's doing a really good job of controlling that aggro. And I'm going to find this guy's name.
Yeah, and unfortunately, Bounty Hunter, I really like seeing this. This is a really good idea for a lot of offlane Bounty Hunters, is if you're given counters, he's actually been fed quite a lot, right? He has a poor man's shield, he was fed regen and counters. If you're able to get counters, not only can you block the camp, but you can also, because of the fact that Shadow Demon, they're going to have to blow counters to unblock the pull. That's one set of sentries down. You have the other set of sentries, you just wait to see them place it. You go in, you wait for a good opportunity and lay down that other sentry that you have, and all of a sudden you have complete free farm in the lane. Mm-hmm. Complete free farm. Like, you're actually able to pick up a lot of CS just being able to come out of Shadow Walk and hit a creep and then go back in, because they don't have any counters left. And with this early build, this allows Bounty Hunter to get really aggressive on Shadow Demon.
He's already started it off. They're going to throw down a sentry wall. They're trying to get that rocket off, and they get the first blood down there. Nice moving up by Sev. And they actually got the kill on Harkon. His name is Harkon. That's how you're supposed to say his name. I told you, man, I have a reference sheet for all this kind of stuff.
I can't believe you have a reference sheet, especially since he's a stand-in. Hmm? Oh, that's hilarious.
No, he's been playing with a couple of teams here and there. Hence I tried to find out how to say his name. And yes, I have. Yeah, man, you gotta have reference sheets like this. Casters don't know everything; they can't recall everything straight away. It's the reason why Bruno has an entire list of like stats and details and stuff. The only person I've actually met that can actually two people that can recall things, which I don't know even how they do it. Middle lane. Disruption. Storm Spirit has no jump out of this one, especially when the DK is going to be there, the clap as well, and Eli's going to go down. Now it's Imaginary Gaming that are sticking it to the Russians. But the only two people that can actually remember details, like very precise details of drafts, and like tournaments, results, even what lanes these heroes went to and the style they played, is Puppy and Goblack. They're the only two I talked to that can remember that. Obviously, there might be some more people out there in the world, but they're the only two people I know that I could actually say, hey man, do you remember what happened at ESWC back in 2011 in like game two of the semifinal? And I'm like, yeah, this. I'm like, what? Crazy ability, man. Crazy ability.
Right now you compare the two offlaners. Bounty Hunter is going to have a really good time in this lane. He can harass Tinker a lot. Now obviously he has to worry about a little bit about two supports being able to rotate and throw down counter ward and catch him out, but he's already countered at least one of the counter wards. So he's in a really good position right now in his lane. He just has to, you know, he's going to be able to pick up a lot of golden experience, whereas Lone Druid is forced to keep on trying to pull with his bear. Did he actually lose his bear? He lost his bear.
Yep.
Wow.
You got him up against a hero.
No. I don't know.
Is it healing?
He sent it back. Yeah.
He's at least lost it once, man. Because that guy's still on cooldown. So he's definitely had to resummon a secondary time. But Android's been doing a pretty good job of keeping it out. Like a quick Lashrak stun, follow up with Edict. He's already preparing himself for a push onto the tower. That's why Dota Stalk's also down here. He could bring in the Lashrak right now and do some considerable damage to this tier 1 tower.
Yeah, Edict mixed with the Riptide and Snare is actually a very dangerous combo. And they're actually going to get a kill here.
Latrak, follow-up stun, and there goes your Edict, but he's going to get on the other side of the bear, and Sky will actually allows that to happen. You need to put that bear directly to Android. Even then, it's going to be a risky kind of thing for him to live. But Lone Druid does go down.
Meanwhile, Imaginary Gaming, they're going to go for their first push. They're going to try and take out this tier 1 tower. That's the one thing.
Oh, disruption catcher. There's going to be an Illumin. It's not going to make this too easy. Both Chen, as well as that SD, took a lot of damage. And Sevi's looking very, very low. Bounded actually able to get the kill before the SD picks him up. And even inside the Marsh Machines, a quick Illumin able to get that kill. But FNG is going to be the return death. Tinker and Death, the Marsh Machine, still middle. A pain in the arse. And right middle lane, Eli getting stunned up. He is so close to his level 6. But Banz pops off his ultimate, and he's not going to get a kill from this, and Eli is now, in fact, level 6.
Yeah. Those small little things, because of the fact they gank Storm Spirit in middle, allows them to be able to be aggressive and dive past that bottom tower because Storm Spirit wasn't level 6 yet and wouldn't be able to respond to those ganks very easily. If he had been level 6, you just would have seen him zip over, and that would have been a free Shadow Demon kill. So that is just those little things. Also, the rotation by Netolic, knowing the fact that one of the ways we used to see Bounty Hunter picked up all the time off lane.
Oh, middle line, Banz, you shouldn't be there. Illumina damage. It was already channeling up. And Eli, all you need to do, even on his low life, he just had to do a quick jump, a pull in, hold DK there, and the damage was dealt.
That's twice now. Keeper of Light has been in a good position. You push against a Bounty Hunter, you take away his tier 1 because he has no ability to defend against it. So Keeper of Light rotating to that offlane, knowing that was going to happen, beautiful timing, and then going middle. Just his positioning is always on spot every single time.
Mm-hmm. Well, man, nice rotation now with Bounty Hunter support. Latrax down here too, and they're already drawing a line. They want to go kill. Yep, and there's the extra support coming in. They realize the pool's going on, so Storm Spirit rotates out from the middle lane. And this is a nice time to do it too. Imaginary Gaming wouldn't really know about this. They even throw down a Sentry Ward just to ensure it. Because Imaginary Gaming will say, well, okay, Eli was damaged in the middle lane. Have a bit of a wander around. Unfortunately now for Imaginary Gaming, they are caught out. But then track gold and, well, pop. And then Edict damage too. That's a level 3 Edict going against that tier 1 tower. Imaginary Gaming hold off on using the Glyph. But because of that, now that tower's out of 524 life points. I'm even seeing a setup on that top lane. But Stork isn't healthy enough, or is he? FNG's coming up. He wants the bear. He wants the bear. With that Illuminate charge, it may be enough. That bear's going to be in range. Stork's going to get there for a Riptide. Yeah, there it goes. Ensnare can follow up. Needs the vision. There goes the Ensnare. Another channel now going to go. There's not enough damage even with that Illuminate. Rockets from Tinker fly again, he pops a bit of a cover marsh the machines off. But it's still, forces Lone Druid out, has to re-summon up his bear, but they take a T1 tower in mid. That's the trade-off.
Yeah. You notice they even threw the Dragonite Ward, that one for stacking. They're going to see Banz is going to go for a stack here because of the fact they have a Keeper of the Light, as well as he should anyway. And they're going to see that and they're going to try and interrupt that eventually. So really, really smart play so far, all around. I'm really enjoying watching FNG. Everything from his warding to his positioning.
He's gonna jump quickly. There's a stun. There's a nuke, and there is gonna be a secondary nuke as well. Good rotation.
Yeah.
And the Lion's actually coming to push up the middle lane. At least that came out from the blue, and then Keeper of the Lights is like, you should be hunting all through here. But they move up instead. How's that Naga looking for her farm? Like, we've seen a lot of kills. Actually, what's our net worth? That's probably our best tell right now. With a couple of kills across the map, we've already got 10 and 8 minutes and a half. So let's just throw CS out the window and see 3.5k up on both DK as well as Tinker. And then almost three heroes on the same. 2.6, 2.5, 2.2. They're the three Netolic heroes. Naga, Storm, and Bounty Hunter, respectively. And then the supports for Netolic have very little to nothing in this. Imaginary Gaming definitely have the advantage in this early point of the game. Especially considering they have a Lone Druid that actually found farm and a purpose. And he's going to find Stork too. Stork? Oh, wow, 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 wow. Thought maybe there'll be a Riptide. He throws the ulti. Oh, what a grouping. What a grouping. This Illuminate's going to do a hell of a lot of damage. Latrak's going to get a very good stun as well. There goes your Illuminate. Latrak follow-up stun. Where is it going? It's not. Holds them out, there's already ensnared. Chen's on the sideline, so they get rid of the healer. Then they get rid of the SD. Both supports down. Latrak burning up while that bear is attacking him. And at the same time, too, FNG, that tornado. Not to mention Tinker just having a great old time with their Marsh Machine's cover fire. And Tolik trying to fight underneath that.
Wow. That was just them being too aggressive on the bear. They, like, really wanted that 300 gold. They're going to go for it again here.
Well, Riptide, they got it. This guy's going to re-summon in 1 second time, though, but they are really low. And Tigger's TPing in onto that Satter. 30 life points on that Satter. The range creep is, in fact, killing it off right now. Lashrak's done will ensure it. And now, with Lashrak up here, Bear comes in range of the tower, poison throwing out. Are we back where we started, where it's just bloodlust on the top lane? Elite, he found the SD. Lashrak, nice follow-up stun. Rockers to fly, hits an FNG. Stalk, still okay. And Elite wants it through the rear, but they're walking again. They walk into the march. Look at FNG's life points. It just dissipates. If he gets an entangle right now, FNG is dead. Two Wiz doesn't get it. And in fact, the lone druid, he overextends himself, trying to get the kill off on the Keeper of the Light, and dies not only to a normal death, but also a track gold kill.
And also losing his bear. Like, he's going to come back, and for a good minute, he will not have that. Yep. This is just getting crazy. But still, even though that last little death was a little silly, Imaginary Gaming is still taking an early gold lead, and the fact, like, all this comes down to the dual lane with Tinker. It was a really smart idea. They were able to pick up Boots of Travel 9 minutes in. I think that's when he picked it up. That's huge, right? Because from here on out, even with all of the fighting, they're still picking up all of the gold and experience in the lanes.
He needed some help. The Purge go off. A bounty was brought in. Now track goes up. FNG gets movement speed and the Illuminate. Now to pick up that SD, in fact. The band's in the back of a haste rune. Bounty Hunter can't go invis just yet. Stunned up once, he's got to go invis. And now Bant, well, he's going to guess with the breeze fire. No, he's not. But, no. March the machines. He will not walk into that bounty. He has to wait it. He doesn't want to risk going past that tier 1 tower and the men and getting stunned up.
Yeah. But it's both the curse and the advantage of a Tinker. The fact that he is such a farm hog, the fact that he can be anywhere and farm every single lane. But in this place, it's a big advantage because the fact that there's so much fighting going on. There are a lot of teams that are, both teams are kind of grouping up. That means you're missing out on farm in those other lanes. Well, Tinker's picking that up for Imaginary Gaming. Netolic, they're missing out on a little bit.
Well, Tinker, she just went down that top lane. I was waiting for that initiation on bottom lane, where, in fact, it now is disruption, catch up, but nice. Lashrak's done, goes into the pulse and the edict damage. They do a hell of a lot. Bounty on a good entangled up and held in position. Chen Yu comes in through the side, and the SD with just his poison when he left before, able to get that kill. And Lashrak looks and gets himself another stun. FNG still trying to go on the run, recalling back in as many people as they possibly can. There's buybacks, and they do come in. Storm Spirit long jump down was thinking about the DK. A nice move from the lone druid. TP's out to the side. Naga throws off the ulti, and they've got bans by himself. Lashrak, however, already used his stun, so this goes into the edict damage as well as a pulse. But with that track already up on him, disruption from the SD, the Master Machine's cover fire, a follow-up stun that is too much damage. There's just too much cover fire for Imaginary Gaming, and this bear keeps the fission up on the Lashrak. It never got pulled back again because of that rocket, 7 HP. That's the reason why there was vision. He caught both the Bounty Hunter. He got in through the rear and he picked up the Tinker. Looks like a Shuri toss with the track. I heard the track at the track spell go off. And he wants back in again. He doesn't have a lot of life points, so he's got to know there's a sentry ward.
Yeah, they're trying to bait him out, but he's not going to take it.
Oh, Courier with a Shadow Amulet. Back to Invis. They're gonna babysit a donkey. That was so close. 9 HP on that courier. It still delivered the rest of the Shadow Blade. And where's Bounty going? He's searching over in the sides, walks past the sentry wall, but they don't have vision of where he's going. And there goes the courier.
They send it to the trees and then they send it home, putting it back into the lane again. Fortunately, though, Bounty Hunter's not there, so they're going to be just fine. That advantage that I was talking about with the Tinker, that's sort of, that disappears when Bounty Hunter is able to get a ton of track gold like this. Like, he's soon going to be level 11. The fact that he is staying alive every single team fight, so he's getting a lot of experience. He's going to have that level 2 track, which is huge. And getting track off on pretty much every single kill that Netolic gets, they're keeping up with that gold advantage. It's still hovering around the 3,000 line for Imaginary Gaming. The experience line is just bouncing up and down over the back and forth over the zero, the neutral line. Mm-hmm. But this is, I'm going to say this is, while the mid game is going to be very, very tough for Netolic to deal with, even though they've got some great setups, I still think they're going to need a lot of farm on Naga Siren to be able to deal with this Tinker, and the Dragonaut obviously is going to be very, very huge. He's got that Shadow Bleed already. He's looking to pick off a lot of these very squishy heroes. Less Drag Storm Spirit. This is just like, it's the same principle as Dragonite versus Puck. Middle.
Checking it out, man. Already with that track up on the DK, movement speed bans, he's not going to get himself away from this one. Already waiting for that last hit, and Storm Spirit's going to take it. Chen now able to fall up his full mech. He had Hand of Cold then, don't know if it really would have been enough to save the DK. Either way you look at it, DK's on the sidelines, Netolic grouped up again, and they're going to force out the middle lane. And they've got to keep her alive behind him. All he's got to do is just keep channeling up these Illuminates. And when you got to track up on the SD, Storm Spirit will jump in and the Illuminates fly over the top. Rockets will fly too, but that comes out from the Tinker. Chen too far out. All the Chen army, in fact, will go down. Pops the Hand of God. He's already popped that mech. And this march on the machines will force Netolic back. And with a Blink Dagger now up on the Tinker, he's able to snipe off that Latrak. But at the same time, talking of sniping, Bounty Hunter able to pick up that Chen and walk back out again. Well, Lone Druid doesn't care, he's pushing at that top lane and Naga's up here to stop him. But on very, very low life, has to be very cautious about doing such a thing.
Yeah, they're just going to keep on pushing that Bounty Hunter. They want more of that track gold. Sky's going to try and take advantage of the split push. Tinker's going to be able to come in.
Oh, Tinker Ooh. TP'd in. The Naga Siren, there's already an Illumina flying off. She has to stop this Naga ulti like right now so the Illumina can hit properly. It's pretty hard there on Sev, who's also taking up that tower damage. It's a very good thing for him. There wasn't a secondary supporter here. An extra TP. Storm Spirit jumps down. He's got Bear as well as Sky. The Illuminate flies up. They could just kill up the Bear and kill off Sky. They're actually going to get the Bears to get bonus the gold out from this kill on the Lone Druid. And Bans, well, you're in a really bad position there, man. FNG, well, he wants to get a kill. Stuns him up. There goes your breath. We need an ensnare or something to control him up because there's a
lot of... He's got gem.
Yep. But he doesn't have his life points once he gets tracked up and spotted. He only just got spotted then too, so gem gets taken back. That sentry ward, that was on max range for that track to go off.
Yeah, that was so unlucky that that track went off, because that would have been a beautiful play if he had, he saw the opportunity. That was very high risk, high reward, but he went for it. He picked off the Keeper Light, took that gem, and thought he could just Shadowblade away, but good on Netolic. They still had some counter wards on them, and then that track was just perfect. So, unfortunately, it didn't pan out, and he ends up trading his own life for a Keeper of the Light, not what you want to see.
Especially for a DK bottom. That needs more items. When we got, yeah, just push onto the T1 tower and bot. And one set up by Tinker before when he cleaned off the creep wave. Just easy maneuvers rounds. That's now, well, advantage to imaginary game. You could expect that to be, though, for as far as map control. You have all out of tier 1 towers down and a tier 2 tower gone in mid. That's against Netolic IU. But you've got a Chen, a DK, a Tinker, and a Lone Druid. If you couldn't achieve that, then something would actually be wrong right now. But at the same time now, you're seeing Orchid up on Storm Spirit, long jump in, and instantly in. Picks off the Chen, moves over to the SD, one to the next. I think I'm going to waste a little bit more time so we can get that track off. Ah, I wasted a little bit too much time, killed him off a little bit too fast. And now March Machines, Bounty, he's going to get to the right. Entangle up on the track, Rocket's flying in too. He's got one charge, keeps him alive a little bit longer. Stalk now comes up as well. Bounty only wants back into this one. He's got to be careful though. Shadow Blaster plus the Dual Breath is keeping him very, very low. And Naga has to pop the ulti, which meant the Illuminate did no damage whatsoever. But Netolic has said, enough is enough. It's one support for two supports. We need to bail ourselves out now. Tinker is not waiting that long. The Urn Charge will keep Stalk alive. Mirror Image is up too.
Nice.
Big Riptide too. With that Mirror Image able to evade out from the Rockets. And then gets another Urn Charge to keep himself alive.
That was a beautiful mirror image. He still would have had needed two rockets.
Storm. Middle lane, Orchid. Easy, easy solo kills. These supports are nothing but cannon fodder.
Yeah, Elite is just doing a fantastic job on his Storm Spirit. He had a hard, hard time early on due to the ganks by Imaginary Gaming. Unfortunately, it comes back to Dragonite. Like, Storm Spirit is being much more effective than this Dragonite. With the Shadow Blade, he's supposed to be able to go around and pick off. He's got three different really good squishy targets to be able to jump on. And I haven't seen him be able to pick off one of them. Like, especially the Storm Spirit, it's the same idea, right? It's a puck, a squishy intelligence hero who relies a lot on mobility.
Yep.
And he just hasn't been able to pick any of them off.
Yeah. Just not working for him, man. Not working for him. Needs some, what the? Oh, okay. So we're taking our Purge unit. Seems Chen now is a big fan of having a Satter Banisher. He's cute. Like, look at that nose. You know, it's like nudge.
He wants to purge the track. I don't know.
We'll find out. Anyway, TP bottom lane. So Tinker, what's he up to now? Ultimate Orb's come up, but he's still a long way off having that Scythe device completed. We are, of course, 20 minutes in, so we can't expect too much of the wall, but then again, as we said before, he's a farm hog. Like, the March of the Machines pushes out the creep waves. They take a lot of the CS away, which means Imaginary Gaming have to find either kills or a lot of space inside their own jungle, ancient stacks, things like these. This is the way they find their farm, while Tinker pushes the lanes out so far they can't actually farm it in a nice, restricted area. Bounty Hunter's moving up to that top lane, or is he? He's hunting around the middle. There's an observer wall down there, so they can see when couriers and heroes move out. And they know exactly where DK is. He's tracked up. That's why the pings came out. And they want to go in. But they're going to move top. Lone Druid still has an entire creep wave with Naga images, which can Riptide as well. So they've already got that extra damage. These images should actually be. Maybe they're not. They just kick off Sky the old-fashioned way. FNG. Well, there's Disruption. Going to save a little bit of time. Where's its Illuminate? There she flies. Knew that one was coming. Going to purge up on FNG, slowing him down. And Naga stalls it up. Throws the ulti. Allows time for repositioning. They've already got the Lone Druid. FNG, where's these rockets? They're not going to fly close enough.
Yeah, they just can't catch the Bounty Hunter. Even if they had that movement, Dust is going to wear off soon.
Oh, man. In they come. There's still a blinding light possibility for Keeper the Light, because he's still got his ultimate up and running. So Storm Spirit jumps in, and already that track is up on the Chen. DK in the middle of this fight. There goes your blinding light. And now, well, over on the side, still, they finally bring down the Chen. Lashrakon down as well. And they move up to the SD. Just one to the next. Rockets to fly. Hit on Stalk as well as Elad. That's fine for them. The track goes back again onto Bans. Man, they can't catch a break, let alone a dire hero.
Yeah, that was a really good ensnare. They ensnared the Dragonite and pretty much walked away from him. Unfortunately, the supports of Imaginary Gaming did the exact same thing, so Bans pretty much put out no damage in that team fight. And it's really beginning to show. Like, even once he has BKB, that isn't going to change the team fights that much. Like, there are no big stunts that he really has to worry about. He really needs more damage. Unfortunately, you just have to go BKB on a Dragonite. Hopefully, you know, level 16 will also be something. But the biggest thing Imaginary Gaming has to fall back on, Netolic isn't doing it yet because it's only 23 minutes in, but they have a ton of turtle. That was the biggest problem I felt with Netolic, is that their mid game wasn't really strong enough to be able to crack open the base. So pushing up against the Tinker, the split push of Lone Druid, even heroes like Chen and Dragonite.
Don't do it, Tinker. He better TP out right now, because Storm, oh, he's over the side. Right, right, right. East, east, east. There it is. And he finds him. Not enough.
Wow.
It was too late. He attacked to the pulling. They will still take out that bottom tower. As FNG is bringing everybody in. You also notice two Naga's build. I noticed Lone Druid was picking up the Sacred Relic, so he is building into a Radiant, so he's trying to get split push up with the Bear, combining it with what Tinker's going to be capable of doing. But now this Bear's going to have a lot of recall troubles, because Radiance has been built up by the Naga Siren. This is such a huge way to farm up, and they're actually picking up Chen's army. They control the Radiant jungle, and they're picking up Chen's army. Maybe even another hero. In comes the TK, pops off the dust, wants the vision, Lashrak, gonna get that stun, holds Bans in position, the Naga ultimate, it keeps him alive on 3 HP. They're gonna put another charge out, that poison's gonna kill him off, there we go, stick charges, keep him alive. He needs another urn charge, but there isn't one available for him. They're just bailing now. Static Remnant's behind, trying to slow up whoever's chasing, Lashrak stuns as well, Naga Siren, now she's the one in trouble. Illuminate's gonna be behind him. And that's going to make Zadrot think a second about this one, especially if there's a Bounty Hunter on the field, which I can assure you there's actually a Storm Spirit and a Bounty Hunter looking for kills. Well, maybe not Bounty. He's got no life. He's back.
Yeah, Elite's just waiting for them to separate. It might be Shattered even here. He's trying to keep up with his teammates. But, so they're just going to get some defensive vision up. The Radiance, we've seen this before in Naga Sirens. It allows you to farm extremely quickly.
This is not doable. Like this is not what they should be doing. There's a track up, and it's already the instant Drac Gold coming the way of the SD. Deathman Storm Spirit takes out the Chen, moves up to the Tinker. He's still got his Orchid available even at this point. Probably should have popped that off to start with. The track is up on set, but he's keeping himself away. Well, should be. He has no mana. He's having to run. And look at Bounty. He's on the chase. Needs that bonus movement speed. What are your gift for phase boots right now? There's your TP out by Tinker.
He's going to pick up BKB, though. BKB, Radiance on Naga Siren, another BKB on Storm Spirit. They're picking up a lot of really good team fight that when they do initiate, they're just going to be able to roll all over Imaginary Gaming. Imaginary Gaming is going to have to play really, really defensive, but against a Radiance Naga Siren, when the team is completely controlling the map, like they're going to lock Imaginary Gaming in their base. So like the way this game is going, unless they lose a huge team fight, they are controlling this game really, really well, and they're getting into their speed where they're going to be looking really, really strong. With the Bounty Hunter, with some good levels on him, even the Leshrac has some really good farm on him. Storm Spirit's obviously a monster. They're looking really, really strong to control the map, and Naga Siren's going to be able to use that advantage to be able to, you know, farm, oh, I don't know, this half of the map. It's just like, that's just the way Radiance with Naga Siren images and Riptide works.
Mm-hmm. Nothing will control her. Whoop! Elite caught a glimpse of Bands. And now Naga starts walking herself back. TP in from the Keeper of the Light just in case he needs some help. In fact, he's already starting to recall. And it's Bounty Hunter who's the one who's brought back. Still inside of his invis, and they don't find anybody. I think Imaginary Gaming realized that once that DK was spotted, that this was not going to work for them. But they are looking at that bear on top. It better get recalled. There it is. Back down to Sky. Imaginary Gaming. Wonder what they're really considering right now. They're going to see four heroes up on the top lane. Well, technically they only see three of them. And they've got one hero that's a long way out. Sev! Storm Spirit overshoots the mark with the Static Remedy. Gets the Vision over on the Tinker. Mana leak, he's dead. 51 seconds. Buyback is available. And wow, no. Are they really? They realize how many people are away. They're going to go in and try Roshan again. There's no Dire Observer Ward, or is there? No, there is. Now they realize it. This is so not ever going to work. And they didn't even kill off the ward. They don't want to risk staying there too long. They don't know how fast Storm Spirit's got there.
Well, they just saw Elite zip across half of the map to pick up that Tinker. I think they're a little bit scared of that happening again. I mean, with the Keeper of the Light, with the Storm Spirit, it allows you to just be able to continually jump like that. So now it's going to be Netolic controlling the Roshan. They're like, look, we're tired of you attempting to do Roshan. We'll take it away. We'll take that temptation away from you. That way you don't feed any more bad team fights.
And they managed to bait out a bear, so there's 300 gold going their way. They're pinging out the fact there's an Observer Ward up on the high ground. FNG just moves back, gets rid of the ward. He'll have to illuminate himself to cover the rest of his team as they're going to come into this very, very small choke point. Naga turned the ulti off, and now in they come. Not really, though. Just became a resummon bear as well as the Chen army, and let the battle begin over Roshan. With the Naga ulti down, they might still feel compass, but while FNG's got enough mana to illuminate, and why the hell is he going to blink dagger?
Who?
The Coddle!
Oh, why not?
He went.
Like, I would prefer Force Staff, but.
He went that over mech, though. There's no mech for their team. Eli's about to jump him. The track's giving them perfect vision inside the pit, not to mention the Static Remnant. And now Tinker also TPing in the middle of this one. There goes your Illuminate. And Roshan, very low on life. Elite, Son of Almost instant. But Roshan, the Agassi Mon of Wasp, snatched up by that Storm Spirit. And Leshrac doing a lot of pulse damage, trying to escape himself back out again. Now, Storm Spirit back alive again. Orca still hasn't been used just yet. He jumps himself out, lets the Illuminate do its work, then moves over to Sev. That was just beautiful. Just jump up, jump down. Nice maneuverability positioning. Leshrac was the only sacrificial lamb.
Yeah, that was still pretty risky of them, but with snatching the Aegis in front of four different heroes, That was pretty clutch by Eli. Really well done, because it shaped the whole entire team fight. You're no longer going to see, even though Dragonite, like, Tinker probably would have been the best pickup for that Aegis, because Dragonite already blowing Dragon Form, you know, he dies. He has no Dragon Form, and he's not much of a carry without that.
Mm-hmm.
And still, though, it would have shaped the team fight, because Storm Spirit wouldn't be able to come back, and that would have been a Tinker pretty much running havoc over the team fight, and it could have been close. But really clutch play there by Eli. And now they're going to use that to control the map. Naga Siren's going to be farming half of it. The other four of his teammates are going to be pushing in towers and farming the other half. And they can just do this for a while until they have Heart, Butterfly. They have a whole bunch of, you know, sheep up on Storm Spirit. All those sort of items. Mech on Keeper of the Light, since you miss mech so much. All those good things.
That would be good. Small things, man. Small critical things. You want to win a team fight. Like, these guys are fighting so much, and you want to fight it without a mech? It seems like madness. It seems like Russian madness.
Well, okay, let's put it this way. Do you think the Keeper of the Light Blast are doing more damage than health he would give to his teammates? Is he doing more damage to the enemy than health would be given to his allies if he had mech? Yeah. It's all about that blink dagger positioning. I don't know. It's interesting. I mean, normally you would see Mac into four staff, but whatever.
Yeah,
I mean,
he's
making it work.
Then
so
you have regen. You have a mana pool. You notice FNG was running so low on his mana pool at the very, very start of that fight, and for most of the fight too. He had to wait out these chakras. It's the reason why you get like four staff, because then you get the plus 10 intelligence. Then you have things like mech, because then you get a couple of stats up. You get armor up and running too. As opposed to this Keeper of the Light, who has 7 armor in total, and now has 5 plus 8. So, do your math on that one. Go from 7 to 13. Dyer's
top tower. What I do like about the Blink Dagger over the Force Staff, though, is the fact that that instant positioning into those really interesting spots where you're not expecting to see a Caudle whatsoever, mm-hmm. that allows for really good blasts, and he's making it work for him. So, you know, to each their own. That's some of the beauty about Dota, is that you can go off the wall items, and as long as you make it work for you, it's you know, it's still fine.
Suppose we can look at it next level too. Like, even when he's in ultimate form, he's using recall. It's like, yeah, I'm gonna just like jump myself into the middle of a team fight and then recall smack bang in the middle. Yeah, positioning, man. The next level thing is now Keeper of the Light and Enigma, the perfect black hole, and perfect Chen is not in the best position for this one. Sitting right next to that high ground area where normally you probably sit on the other side and just let your creeps attack this region and attack through the tree line. Put himself in a risky position, lose his life because of it.
Now they're going to start taking away all the towers away from Imaginary Gaming. And Tinker's still going to have to be very, very careful, because at any point in time, whenever he teleports in, that's the biggest thing about going up against Tinker, is setting down traps, right? Whether it's smoking up on a wave that's pushing in that you think Tinker's going to teleport into, or just one hero, like Bounty Hunter, Storm Spirit, even Naga Siren, they're all very good at catching out this Tinker when he teleports to the side lane. So even that, they don't even have that to be able to assure them some sort of room. It's just pure turtle from here on out.
Mm-hmm. Well, the beautiful thing is they have a March of the Machines, so unless we see Mass Blade Mail up on Netolic, that March of the Machines will keep doing its job. I would actually like to see Mass Blade Mail. Just to kill off that Tinker, the old, like, the Alliance way. Storm Spirit, jump, top, bottom lane. He's still got this Orchid available. He's not doing the pull just yet, and Tinker TP'd himself in too. Just harassment forces him off that tower. Eli doesn't really have a lot of mana left to play around with. They're even de-warning up. Regeneration rune on bottom. I'm guessing they flagged that for him. I'm hoping somebody flagged that for him. There's a regeneration rune on bottom lane, man. Go pick it up. Oh, they find Sky. Track up on him. Bear weren't getting entangled. But they get a lot of heroes moving in for Imaginary Gaming. In fact, their entire lineup by Tinker, who just TP'd top. And they'll find, to start with, Stalk, Bear, and Snare will go off. See how much damage they got to bring down a Bear. And the answer is more than enough.
What was that? What's that little animation when Bear dies?
I didn't see it, man.
He, like, fell down on the ground, and then, like, he farted glitter, and he popped up for a second. I don't know.
He farted glitter?
Yeah, man. It was weird.
I could imagine, like, you've got him, like, dropping to the ground, and like, the boom sound, and then you've got, like, the dust which would fly out around him because he upsets the terrain around him. I could imagine that.
It was like the resummon return.
The farting glitter?
Yeah. I'm telling you, man, I've seen it. I ain't crazy.
You've actually seen someone fart glitter?
Well, I saw the bear do it just now. All right.
I suppose that's as close as we get to the real thing ever.
This is what happens. See, they're just going to split off, and they're going to farm up, and we're going to be left with nothing to talk about except for those ganks that are going to be happening. Whether Imaginary Gaming is going to be smoking up and trying to get some map control back, or if it's going to be Netolic going, all right, you're stepping a little out of bounds here. You're stepping over the line. Time for me to punish you. And like, for example, the Tinker, those sort of situations where they see him pushing into the side lanes, and Storm Spirit, like, look at him. He's just he throws down one March of the Machines. Usually, like, you get, like, at least two off.
Yeah.
He throws down one March of the Machines, blinks, and teleports away. He's so scared.
You'd be very, very concerned, man. But Storm Spirit shut himself up on the top lane now. What are you just coming for Stork? He's got a full heart now, done with this Radiance. This is force time for Netolic if they want to. Like, we've got a Storm Spirit with a regeneration rune. He can hold off this bottom lane, spamming up as much mana as he wants to, and then Keeper of the Light will just pop the ulti and bring him in. Very, very simple to do. And which means the trade goes the way of Netolic. And there's no fortification for the Radiant side. Yeah. There's the jump. He's wasting their time. All he's doing is wasting their time. Through and through. Pops the regeneration rune. They hold a tier 2 tower, and the tier 2 tower is lost for Imaginary Gaming. And how long's it going to be before next row, Sean? It's got, well, yeah. Another roughly 4 minutes. Roughly.
Mm-hmm.
But they want top. Bounty Hunter's looking at Sky. There's already the recall trying to bring that Storm Spirit in. And, tactical. Tactical. Storm Spirit lagging up. Where is he? He's right behind. He can jump this. He'll just jump. There goes the jump. Tinker was trying to TP into that range creep, and then that range creep died off, so there's no TP for it. And now not only do they get the lone druid, but they're going to pick up the DK to boot with a BKB up on Eli. Track gold on the SD. He doesn't have another jump in him, but there's a shuri toss from the bounty hunter. There'll be enough. And then they pop the meg charge, we'll turn around, DK ball back. And Tinker, March of the Machines. And Naga says no. They kind of should be looking at the Tinker here. Out of everyone they've got, the Tinker is their main objective. And they've even got a creep wave from the Dire side to move down that far. Jump up, jump down, Android low on life. He's got 30 life points right now. And he's actually living not long enough through this one. They were still able to get that last hit out from the Chen, but he loses his own life for it. Tinker ball back into this game. So now both heroes are alive for Imaginary Gaming and buyback heroes. But you get a March of the Machine. So technically there's like 5 million different heroes that are suiciding themselves into Netolic right now as Bounty Hunter takes a lot of damage. Gets himself in biz. Gets Nern charged to bring himself back up again. Dota Stalk getting stunned up quickly. Are they going to come back in to take the racks for this? Even without the Lashrak? Or do they just say no? No, they say no. TP out. There's a mid tower to deal with. And there's still a tier 2 tower in bottom lane to take as well.
I'm sorry. Your chat is just showing that people can fart glitter in many different forms of links and stories, so. It's what happens when you bring me on to cast with you, Toby.
I'm not really sure I want to kind of follow that now.
Oh, man. Well, I mean, I thought they were going to farm up for another 5 or 6 minutes. Like, I was thinking the 40 to 45 minute mark is when Netolic is going to finally have enough farm, and then I looked at the gold graph, and I didn't realize that they were, at the time, they were sitting about 15,000 goldy. Now, it's 20,000.
Haste! It's all about track money, man. Level 3 track money, and Chen is gonna get solo killed. He's a Desolator. Meg Charge won't save. In fact, his Hellbear almost blocked him up to kill him off, but there was no way he's gonna survive against the bounty anyway. And then Tinker, Oh, wow, that's even a bigger blow. If they snipe off even one more hero here from the middle lane, it's gonna be at least one Rax. At least one Rax. And there it is. Oh, look at that damage! Pop! Goes the SD.
Yep.
And now they keep a look at the bear. The bear literally is like bedazzled by glitter. Had to be stopped up by the Naga ulti, and now they want bans. Ensnare, mirror image to start with. I'll just kill off the bear. The bear's there, why not? They get it, Sky doesn't have a resummon for 18 seconds. And DK, inside his BKB, was held back, trying to kill off these damn mirror images that are walking around with, like, heart buff. Are they going to finally go in through the top? Because it's taking some sweet-ass time before they finish off a Rax. Tinker's only dead for another 9 seconds, so they don't have a lot of time here. And in they go.
There
in. Storm! Talk about in! He's deep in! He's balls deep in! Looking for him, and he wants the Chen. He's going to get him too. Latrak follow-up stun. But Bans, it's just too far to go back to base. Marsh Machine's cover fire is there again. Rockets, lasers, Storm Spirit are looking too healthy. And he will go down right now, but top Rax merely was taken. The Bear's back up again. He's looking for a kill on Storm. That Bounty Hunter just evaporates the Tinker. Chases down Sky, Shuri Toss, Mini Stun, and GG. Yeah. Is the call. Netolic RU will now face up against the Danes. Flip side. In another best of three matchup. The game will start almost instantly is the call. And we will see which one of these two teams will go home and which one of these teams will go to Poland. That's what's at stake, man. There's so much at stake for the next game. The land final in Poland? Hell yeah.
Yeah.
But we'll see. Yeah. We'll see how it all unfolds, man. Short break, peoples. Short break coming up. Stay tuned. More action on the way. Not only just the RaidCall EMS tonight, but we will also be doing the defense tiebreaker between Kaipi, Dignitas, and Team Liquid. Should be one hell of a matchup, people. Should be one hell of a matchup. So stay tuned. Great Dota coming your way all night tonight. We'll see you shortly.